Part 4 of our journey through the basics of QMK, and we're ready to start flashing. If you're still struggling to get QMK set up, then check out the other videos in the playlist. If you've been tweaking your layout and have it to a point where you're ready to try it out, then this is the episode that you've been waiting for. Make sure you've got a key that will send the reset code so your keyboard can be flashed without you having to push the little button on the PCB. The file that you need to flash needs to be compiled before you can send it over to your keyboard. You can do the compiling and flashing separately or in one go. I'll show you how to do both. First, let's assume you're not ready to flash your firmware to your keyboard. Maybe you don't actually have it yet and you're just killing time until it arrives. Open up your MSys2 terminal and navigate to your QMK firmware folder. Note that you must be in this folder for things to work as they should. The command for compiling your hex file is as follows. Make, and then a space followed by the directory name for your keyboard, and then a colon followed by your keymap directory name. For the Satan GH60 and my layout, it would look like this. Make Satan Chokkan, which I'm really uncomfortable about typing into a computer and even less so about saying it out loud. If all goes well, you'll find a hex file in the QMK firmware directory. If it doesn't, then you'll need to take a look at the error report for a hint as to how it messed up. I'd love to give tech support to everyone that watches this video, but you'll probably have better luck if you take a good look at the error, which should include a line number and a message telling you what the error was. If you want to compile the firmware and flash your keyboard with one command, all you need to do is add one of the following to the end of the previous command. If your keyboard is running ChibiOS on a Teensy 3 or a Teensy LC or something with an ARM processor, you need the dfu util command. If you're using a Teensy 2, which many hand-wired keyboards do, then you type Teensy. If you're using something like a Pro Micro or one of its clones, you need AVRDude. If you're not sure which option you need, take a look in the README for the keyboard and it should tell you. In most cases, and in the case of my Satan GX60, DFU is what you'll use. Once you execute the command, you'll need to put your keyboard into flashing mode by pressing the button or hitting the key combination you set up in your keymap. After that, the firmware will compile and will be flashed to your device. It's a really smooth process and it's getting smoother all the time, but errors will crop up. Most of the time, it will be your fault. Make sure brackets and braces are properly closed. Watch out for typos in your keycodes. Use the find function in your text editor to track them down. Next episode, we'll dig into the rules and config files and see what they do. I'll see you then.